This episode takes place in Alabama. We started out just outside of Birmingham and drove down to Sylacauga. From there, we went to the Talladega National Forest and on to the start of the 600-1 trail. For today's trail, I was using my 2006 LJ Rubicon. And joining us was Jim and Lisa in their CJ7. We started the trail at the south side of the 600-1. It's a little rocky, with some mud here and there, but nothing too bad. It was actually quite a nice drive. A well-known spot on this trail is where the power lines cross it. We stopped to take a couple of pictures. A little further on, there are cliffs, and we stopped here to have lunch. The road from the power lines to the north entrance is very well maintained, and it's just like a normal dirt road. It was so well maintained that we missed the turn off to the lookout tower. The rest of the trail was an easy drive on dirt roads. We turned off the road a little early and made a detour into the Bull's Gap trailhead. After making a U-turn in the trailhead parking lot, we got it back on the road for the short jump to the entrance to 600-1. The trail was not too rough at all. There were a few rocky patches here and there and some gullies that we needed to cross. Other than that, the going was good. As it was the middle of winter, the trees had lost all their leaves, and it was great being able to see through the forest. Spots where you had to choose your lines to make sure you didn't hit anything on your undercarriage. Nothing major, but if you do have a low slung vehicle, be careful of these areas. Jim has put very soft leaf springs on his CJ, and this allowed it to flex very well. Lines properly, you were quickly rewarded with a thud underneath your vehicle. Every now and again, there was a little bit of mud on the trail. took some of the downhills very slowly. This allowed plenty of time for the boys to run ahead and tape us coming down. Further down the trail, we started seeing a little bit more slope on some of the sections. It didn't take us long before we reached the top of the hill where the power lines crossed the road. After taking photographs and enjoying the great views at the power lines, we continued on down the road. Our next stop was at Sherman Cliffs, where we took a minute to enjoy lunch.
We're going to see if we're going to have lunch here.
The views from the cliff are spectacular, and it's a must to stop here and enjoy this spot. With happy tummies, we finished the rest of 600-1 on easy dirt roads. From the north entry of the 600-1 trail, there is a small section of tar road that you need to take to get to the south entry of the 600-2 trail. The paved road between the north entry to 600-1 and the turn off to 600-2 was a good change from the morning's slow driving. Just like 600-1, the 600-2 trail runs atop of the mountain ridge. At the start of the trail there was some construction. You pass that and then head on down the road. The first obstacle we ran into was a muddy stretch. After that, there were some deep erosion ruts in the road. The remainder of the trail was straightforward, and it was not long before we arrived at the crossroads. We decided not to continue with the trail, but if you wanted to, you could follow the ridge to the north entry of the 600-2. Finding the south entry to 600-2 is not too complicated when you turn off the main road. Just follow the road over the railroad tracks and drive across the bridge. I once again took the lead as we set off down the start of 600-2. It wasn't long before we arrived at the muddy section, and I was first to go through. Shortly thereafter, we ran into the rutted section of the road. We decided that the best line was to cross the ruts at a few places. This caused the Jeep to cross-axle itself. You can hear the suspension creaking and groaning as it articulates through the ruts. Jim decided that the best line for him was to stay on the other side of the ruts. Decided to cross over too. The rest of the trail wasn't too bad, with a few little rocky sections and some gullies here and there. Thank you. Just before we reached the crossroads, we found this nice rocky climb. This would be our last section for the day. It was already fairly late on a winter's afternoon. We decided it would probably be best to head home, and we called it a day and turned off 600-2 on the crossroads. Stay tuned, or better yet, subscribe for more videos of the road less explored.